So what happens if you are just starting as an artist and you don't have all these fabulous mixed media products? Can you still do some beauties? Let me show you my very low cost project. And it's Asia Marke here. Welcome to my channel. I realized lately that the projects I made and I like the most are quite simple. Because I was working and I'm working in DT teams, I am obliged to use their products, and I do that. And sometimes I tend to actually use a lot of them in one project, which makes me a little bit confused at the moment. Also, well, it's a harder job, it takes longer, and I am not necessarily always happy with my products, with my projects. Today I decided to show you a very easy page. So not only the page which is on budget or low cost, but also a page which is quite minimalistic and the page which I like very much. I am so sorry for talking a little bit weirdly. I have no idea, today is very bad voiceover day for me. I am recording and deleting and recording and deleting, I just hate it. But let me come back to the page. So you are seeing me using a Fiskars, that's Fiskars, yes, using Fiskars stencil with circles, and I added some modeling paste. You're gonna get a list of all the products in the description box below, as always. And now, guys, I'm using a tool which has replaceable endings, and this ending in particular, it's one which you would use to make holes in the paper. And I apply the paste in the circle, and now I'm trying to do lines like concentric, I think, all over the paste while it's still wet. This is very important, and you have to have a piece of cloth or a piece of tissue on the side to remove the excess of the paste from the tool. And so I'm going like that. The circles are not perfect, and this is not the purpose of that. If I wanted to have a perfect circles, I would probably use some kind of stencil, even though right now I don't even have a stencil which is similar to that, and it's actually impossible to to have a stencil with the circles like that. They have to be attached, of course, at one point. But if you, of course, don't have a Fiskars stencil like I am using, you can just simply trace the circle on the page and just with a crayon, and just later add the modeling paste and go ahead with sculpting, I think, I don't know, or making relief better. So the next step is drying it perfectly, and look how it looks like. The circles are there, they are not perfect. If you know me, or for those who know me, I am very far from being a perfectionist in what I'm doing. I'm trying my best, but it doesn't have to be perfect to be pleasing to the eye. And to color the circle, I decided to use two magicals, pink and gray. Later you'll notice that the gray was not the best choice, because I wanted something which is quite contrasting with the pink, quite strong, and the gray was not that. But for now, you see me, I removed a tiny bit of powder, put it on the working surface, and then added the water by spraying. I learned all my mistakes. I always cover now the project I'm working on with my hand, because I sprayed so many times water and the powder just goes all over the place. So very often the powder landed in the places I didn't want it to land on the project. And as you can see me, I sprayed a little the paper, and then I'm applying the magicals. I start with the darker one, and then I'm gonna add the brighter one, but you know, you can do it the other way around, that really doesn't matter. Also, you can see a slight warping on the page, because simply I did not use any primer underneath. I like to work like that. I don't have to have a primer to work. If there is a small warping, I'm always trying to dry it later with the heat gun on both sides, so from the front and from the back, and like that warping usually disappears perfectly. And so now I am adding with another brush a little bit of pink, and then I'm gonna again spray some water so the paints will move more freely. And this is the moment when I realize my gray, I told you guys I really have a very bad voiceover day today, but my gray was not strong enough, so I decided to use blazing black. On top of that, I could have done that with the brush, but I wanted to have some splatter around the circle. So I said to myself, I'll spray a tiny bit just, and like that I will have a splatter on the outside, and I will not cover completely the color from underneath. And that's what's happened, and I am happy with that. And on top of that, when you dry the blazing black, it's actually changing the color, is not as strong as it was, so that's perfect. And this is one of my favorite products. I bought it in Germany at my sister's. My sister is living in Frankfurt. And it's a product from Ricoh Design. Ricoh Design is a very good company. I never work for them, so this is not a publicity of any kind, but it's a very good company and quite cheap. And so I'm buying the products wherever I can, whenever I go to Frankfurt. And this is an adhesive for the magical leaf or for golden foil or things like that, and it's in a form of a liquid glue, which is perfect because you can do splatter there. So that's what I've done, and I randomly kind of made the circles with the glue also, and now I'm using a magical leaf or golden foil. I really don't know how this one in particular is called, because this one actually I bought in a pawn shop. And it cost me, I don't know, maybe 1 euro, maybe not. And the idea is to just tear a small pieces, place it on the glue, which is already kind of dry. You have to wait around 5 minutes, or just go for like, I don't know, 30 seconds over it with the heat gun. And then you place it, and then for me the best way is to remove the excess with the brush. So you see me working here like that. And also, in the places you've done splatter, you're gonna have these small, tiny, irregular dots, which is really, really nice. I cannot even believe how long it's been since I've done a very low cost and very minimalistic project, and also a project with circles. And I absolutely adore circles. I could use them everywhere. I don't know, there is this perfection about the circle in itself. And this really attracts my eyes so much, and it makes me calmer. And all the projects I ever done with circles as a focal point, I really, really loved. And now when I removed all the excess with the brush, and you see me, I'm working here quite hard. I've decided to add some focal point, and for a focal point I actually use some of the paper elements. I just doodled once when I was sitting and probably watching something, because when I watch things, and that doesn't happen very often, when I watch some series or things like that, I actually cannot just stay without moving. I have to do something, so I doodle them on the black paper with a white pen, and I like them so much that I decided to fuzzy cut them, and now they are my focal point, and in the background there is this beautiful circle, and that's basically all there is for this page. I really wanted to leave it like that. Already when I used this golden pinkish color, it's already so rich that I really don't need to, I don't feel like I need to add something else. I think that it's already enough for what it is on the page. And the only last thing, of course, it's the sentiment, because for me art journaling is always putting the sentiments which means something, either with the page or for me, usually it has to be both. So I'm really trying, I'm not taking the first one I find, I really look at them carefully and try to match them to the page. And that's it guys, And as I said, you don't need to have a lot. And usually when you have less, your imagination is working much better. So don't ever get discouraged and continue crafting, continue doing your art. And I hope I'll see you in the next video. Have a lovely day and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button. Bye bye guys.